outside. You can just walk outside. It's cold. How cold is it?
Real cold.
Real cold.
We're continuing to just watch those temperatures drop. Honestly, you lose track, I think, once you start to go into those sub-zero temperatures of how cold it actually is, because it all just kind of starts to feel the same. It just hurts a little bit. 11 degrees. Right now, it's feeling like it because winds are remaining calm, but we know it only takes a light breeze to suddenly feel like 11 below, and that's likely to be the case for many of us at different points throughout tomorrow. Waking up around the metro, cloudy skies quickly transitioning into some light snow showers for us, but only lasting late morning into the early afternoon. I don't expect this to have a huge impact, but there will be some covered roadways out there that you'll want to watch out for. And then eventually we'll warm up to a whopping 10 degrees, but that'll only feel like 4 below. Maybe even a little bit of sunshine in there before we let the sun set. Let's go hour by hour so we can see the snow come on in. 10 a.m., you can see it starting to move in on the metro, mostly taking areas west of I-35 with a bit more of a focus to those spots to the south of I-80. That's where I expect higher accumulation, not just for tomorrow, but over the next few days. This starts to depart as we head into the afternoon, and then looking towards Sunday, another quick round. There it is, down to the southwest. Some of us might miss out on this, to say the least, as this continues to just clip us throughout the afternoon. But then we got another round on Monday that soars on through and then eventually pushes out as we get into the afternoon hours. So three different rounds in there. Let's add them up. Looking at your Saturday, we're looking around an inch and a half for some spots in the metro. The farther north you go, the more of a dusting it is. The farther south, the higher accumulation. Same goes as we add a little bit more onto Sunday, maybe a couple tenths of an inch around the metro. Maybe 3 or 4 inches in total when you add Saturday and Sunday down to the southwest. Those numbers get a bit higher as we add in Monday. So our 3-day accumulations there, you can see mostly ranging from around an inch to the north to as high as maybe 5 inches to the south. It all just depends on where you are. You can kind of divide that up there just looking around central Iowa, about 2.5 inches for Marshalltown, about 4 inches for Creston over 3 days that we expect to accumulate. But we know that the wind chills are going to be brutal too, and it all depends on where you are. So let's look at this by location. Fort Dodge tomorrow morning, waking up feeling like 10 below. Same for your Sunday, except worse. And then Monday, feeling like 21 below zero, one of our coldest spots. Lots, I bet. Even colder for areas up to the northeast. Looking around Des Moines, I expect you to be feeling like 7 below for tomorrow morning and then teens below zero for both Sunday and Monday. And it's a pretty similar outlook even as far south as Lamoni. It's a little bit more comfortable to start things off on Saturday morning, but we continue to feel like teens below zero as we get into the start of next week. And speaking of next week, a full week of sub-zero temperatures for your overnight hours. I mean, my goodness, how cold that will be. Look at Friday, Saturday, even 10, 11 below. Those are the air temperatures, so you can imagine what it feels like, possibly even looking at a sub-zero daytime high next Saturday. That's going to be brutal. We're going to be getting you ready for it throughout all of next week. We may see a couple more rounds of quick snow showers in there that we'll continue to track, but for now, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, those are your weather aware days.
Whew, okay.